Guys, I hope the weekend is going super duper well with you. And yes, it's been a hectic weekend because my kids have been having their annual performances going on, and it is an absolute pleasure to watch the kids. The little ones have been putting in so much of effort, and I'm in total awe of the school and the staff, the way the whole thing has been carried off. And I know so many of you may not resonate with what I'm saying, but I'm sure mothers and fathers would be, because when you see the efforts of your little ones going up on the stage and performing, you know, you exactly know, you connect with them, and you know so much of efforts have been going in. And when they put up that performance on the stage, you are certainly a proud parent up there. So yes, in the middle of this, I have been, of course, found some time to read on high performance, which is my favorite topic. And guess what? I found a beautiful piece from this book from a mentor called High Performance Habits from Brendan Bouchard. And what I read today really resonated with me so much from what I've been observing in people and what I've been seeing, that I want to be sharing that bit in today's video. Now, you've been knowing there are a lot of people around you who are doing good. Maybe they would be good in a certain field, or, you know, various things. Some may be good at something. Some people may be good at something else. But one thing that is that particularly stands out about high performers is they have this unique set of character, because and I would call this a trap, which it could be you, it could be me, it could be anyone who would be falling in this trap. But this trap is that so many of them feel that they are superior. It can come at any point of time in your career. It can come right now, it can come in future. But once you start excelling in something, this is a very normal trap that we fall into. We start feeling that we are superior to those around us, and that's an important one. So it's always a word of caution that as you get more successful, you can quickly fall prey to this trap that I'm talking, the trap of superiority. It's because, you know, it's common sense. All of us are already guilty. We have these kind of thoughts and actions that demonstrate the feeling of superiority. You may excel at a project compared to your peers. That may lead to the feeling of security. You may crack something which a lot of people around you are not able to crack. You may exceed, you may excel at building a relationship with your spouse which so many of others are not able to build. It is these little thoughts and actions that lead you to the thoughts and actions of superiority. So while, you know, you may tell me, I don't fit this bill, you know, I don't belong here. So while you may be someone who's not demonstrating maybe a bombastic ego, but you know, the trap of superiority has hundreds of degrees. So you don't know the degree that you're fitting in right now, because the trap of superiority is such that it will drag you one quarter inch at a time. So while you may not feel that you're completely off track, but it's dragging you. It's dragging you some point of time, somewhere in life or the other. So you have to, the sooner you recognize the trap, that's better for you. Because what happens is, once you're into this trap, you start losing awareness of all the other powers that you have. What happens is, you stop asking people for their opinions on how you're doing. You stop asking for their input or help, because you think that you're always right. So all these are the little signs, because little signs to get you know that, you know, the trap of superiority has had a firm hold on you, and you start acting like a jerk, a total jerk. Trust me, guys, I've seen people, they start acting out like jerks because they feel they're superior and much better. They dismiss people outright, and they literally speaks in tones of condescension, and that is so demeaning to those people around you. But the problem is, you don't recognize when you're doing it. You recognize it much after. But while this all may seem bad news to you, but the good news is that you can learn to spot exactly when and how these thoughts would arise in your mind. It would just happen, you know, gradually. So how do you identify this whole thing? How do you identify this whole feeling of superiority? Thank you, Maisha. How do you identify that? What are those, what are those triggers, or what are those things that you start to observe in yourself that you can make out? Maybe I'm beginning to feel this, and maybe I shouldn't be feeling this. Well, the number one thing is that you think that you're better off than another person, or maybe a group of people appears that you're working in. That is one thing that you may feel. The second indication could be you're so amazingly good at whatever you do that you don't feel you need any feedback, any guidance, or any kind of support in your life. guys, that is the worst thing to do. But that's it. That's true. You may start feeling that, right? The third thing is that you feel that you automatically deserve people's attention. You deserve people's admiration. Why is that so? Because, you know, because you feel that you deserve the admiration because of who you are or whatever you've accomplished till now. So you feel that you deserve it. Guys, beware, this is a trap. The moment you feel you deserve something, that's the thing that you need to hold yourself and pinch yourself, because none of us deserve anything. Whatever you do, because of your hard work and because of the change that you cause in your life and people's lives, that's it, full stop. You don't deserve anything more just because of what you've accomplished, right? And the fourth and the most important thing is you feel that people around you don't understand you. And that's a big one. I've seen so many people come, there's so many of my high performance coaching clients, they come up to me and tell me that, you know, I have done so many things, I've accomplished so much, but the thing is, Meghna, you know, people don't understand me. That's the trap, guys. That's a superiority trap if you feel that. So if any of these four signs resonate with you, think that maybe you're somewhere near or maybe you're about to fall into this trap, and beware. Because if any of these realities are constantly acting and playing in your life, then maybe you've begun to decline the path of your success, but you don't know it yet. Right. So yeah, I know you may not like to hear this, but then sometimes, guys, it's time to pop the bubble that you live in. So many of times we it comes into phases, right? There have we get into phases where we live in a sort of bubble and we don't realize the realities. But the thing is, sometimes it's time to pop this bubble. So come on, guys, let's get it straight. I don't want to mince around the words, but you're not the first entrepreneur to face the financial ruin, are you? If you're crying about it, you're not the first one. You're not the first person to be cheated on love. You're the first person who's facing a lot of shit in their relationship. All of us are. You're not the first person to deal with depression. You are not the first person to deal with any kind of addiction. There have been people before this. This is something that has been dealt with them earlier. So what do you do? You know, of all the high performing people, of all the successful people, there's rarely a person who feels that, you know, they are at the top. There's rarely someone high performers, they never feel that they're at the top, which is because that they mostly feel that they are just getting started. If someone you feel has been a great successful person or has accomplished a lot, you go and ask them, just have a word with them, and this is all they'll tell you. If you compliment them, they'll tell you this straight away. Oh, thank you so much, but I feel I'm just getting started. I have lots to learn. I'm on the path, or the journey is still on, whatever it is. But it's never this, they raise up the call and they tell you, thank you so much. It doesn't work that way, right? So because they understand that they're students for life, no matter how much they've accomplished, they understand that they still have miles and miles to go, right? And it is this attitude, guys, that makes them the way they are. That makes them high performers. So in this video, I just want to share three important things that you can do to avoid yourself feeling on the trap of superiority. The first thing, guys, that you can do is whatever stage that of life that you're in, you know, seek ideas from others. Ask people, how can you improve anything that you're doing? You're speaking, you're painting, or you're a doctor who's treating people. Ask people, how am I doing? How can I improve? Because learning is one thing that is certain to keep your humility intact, super intact. That's a no-brainer completely, guys. The second thing is, what you can do is, if you feel that whatever you're thinking or whatever your ideas are, they've never been challenged. You think that your growth stopped out, maybe you're plateauing, hire a coach. Hire someone who will challenge you. Hire someone who will challenge everything that you do. It could be a coach, it could be a trainer, it could be a therapist, it could be anyone, right? And the third one is, instead of feeling that, that agony feeling that people don't trust you, people don't understand you, take responsibility and take ownership of your own actions. Nobody stops you from doing that, right? So reflect on your role. Whenever you had a conflict, reflect on your role. Just ask yourself, you know, are you distorting the situation to make yourself feel that you have been misunderstood, or are you trying to make excuses? Are you trying to play the victim role in the situation? Or, you know, ask yourself, what is it that I might know about the situation that I don't already know? This is the one that will bring the truth into effect, that will really bring the truth into light. Otherwise, you can go on and on and on, whatever you feel, right? So it is these three things, guys. The first thing is, ask for feedback. The second thing is hire someone to challenge you, to make your growth above the plateau level. And the third one is, you know, don't believe in people don't understand me. Go out there and take responsibility for your own action. That's an important one, guys. These three things will really keep you grounded. Yeah. And, you know, these three suggestions are there to make you humble, grounded, effective. You can say respectful, and ultimately help you sustain the level of success that you've already wanted and build a life maybe that you're proud of, guys. These are the little things. I know these are oft ignored, but these are important, right? So this is an important discussion on high performance, guys. And for those of you who are keen on attending the masterclass, the next one is happening next week, guys. So be sure to attend malkanhpclass.com and register yourself for the next masterclass, which is happening soon. And yes, I'm eager to see you all on live on the masterclass. See you guys. Have a great night. Bye-bye.